Go.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Today I will teach you about the material of learning. Before I start the learning, I want to introduce myself first. My name is Muhammad Hamza Azmi. I'm from 7th class and I'm 12 years old. And let's pray first. Please repeat after me. Rabbi zidni ilman.
Rabbi zidni ilman.
Warzuqni fahman.
Warzuqni fahman.
Waj'alni minas solihin.
Waj'alni minas solihin.
Okay? What will we learn? We will learn about the meaning of zalim, hadith about zalim, type of zalim, and example of the zalim. First, what is zalim? Zalim in language means putting something out of place. But in terms, zalim means doing something that is outside of the corridor of the truth, either because it's less or more than the limits. Hadith about zalim. So the hadith is Attaqullah wa iyyakum wazulma wa inna zulma zulmatu yawm al-qiyamah. It means be fearful of Allah, all of you, and be afraid of zalim, because it will become the darkness in the day of judgment. Type of zalim. Actually, there are many types of zalim, but here I will explain history. So the first is zalim to Allah, then zalim to others, and then zalim to yourself. Example of zalim. Example of zalim to Allah is deny Allah, deny Allah, syirik, and not confessing faith in Allah. Zalim to others, disturbing others, lying, stealing, or mocking. And zalim to yourself is committing sin, setting fire, and being lazy. Okay, here's the case. What is the meaning of zalim in language?
Putting some.
Putting what?
Ini English.
Yalah, English.
Yeah, putting some. Putting some. Disturbing.
Putting something on the taste.
What?
Putting something on the taste.
Of the flesh.
Yeah. Putting something out of place.
Disturbing, stealing, lying.
Okay, maybe that's all from me. I'm sorry if I have mistake. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.